And Rohan is he's a chaser on Chasing News, which is the show I host on Fox Television that airs every weeknight. Rohan, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
And nice to see you again today, Bill.
Yeah, it's exactly right. It's this day has never. This day's not going to end. You know, it started bright and early from there to the show to here. So I was hoping you could share this story with the audience, because what you shared today, and now this you're going to air this. This will air tomorrow on tomorrow's show. But I wanted everyone to get just a glimpse of what happens when one person. So just tell me quick the story. How did it start and what happened?
Yeah, absolutely. April Steck was a mom from Westfield that spent a lot of time in Linden. That's right there. She befriended a man named Clinton Kelly, who fell on some hard times in 2011, ended up homeless on the streets, beaten, survived some of the most horrible weather conditions you can imagine. And she brought him some food one day, told her a joke, and they cultivated, you know, a nice, hello relationship. One day they found him, and he was severely beaten, worse than they've ever seen in their life. They asked him if he was okay. He said he was hungry. They took him to a hospital. And since that point, about a month ago, he's been completely, you know, rehabilitated. He's walking with a cane. They found him housing. They gave him food. They gave him hope. And they contacted him with his daughter in North Carolina, who has opened her arms to him to come home and live with them. And it's just a fantastic story.
Now, Rohan, let me ask you. So this mom in Westfield, she actually brought Clinton Kelly. So the guy's 59 years old. He's got a kid in North Carolina. As you explained to me, that he had been robbed. So his wallet had $2 in it.
Correct.
And one piece of paper.
$2, the beating became worse.
Right, because the guys felt ripped off, whoever attacked him in the first place. But there was also a piece of paper, right, in his wallet that had his daughter's address on it.
Yeah, absolutely. So that was his, you know, the only contact information he had for his daughter. And, you know, you get to your lowest point. They lost touch for 4 years. You know, sometimes you have to, you feel so down on your luck that maybe you don't feel like it's time for you to reach out, you know what I mean? And these people got him rehabilitated in a way that I've been thinking about it all day. You can see what he looks like in a little clip on the show tonight.
So let me ask you now, you were with them at City Hall, right? You went to, was Clinton there, or is he already on his way to North Carolina?
Yeah, no, it was amazing. April, her boyfriend, Brian.
Wait, April is the woman in Westfield who essentially rescued this guy.
Yeah, absolutely. The Hope Foundation heard about it on Facebook. There was a Facebook campaign created. Henry and Christina of the Hope Foundation were there, too. All the children, all April and Brian's children, they call him Uncle Clinton. Everybody calls him Uncle Clinton. He's a part of the family, and they love him so much. Big embraces, hugs, you know, tears, fantastic.
Now,
the mayor of Linden came down as well, and he joined us. And had some wonderful words for the people of this town.
So did they actually invited this guy into their home to have dinner? Like, he sat with the family at dinner in their house.
Oh, they absolutely did. They've been together on many occasions. It's not an impersonal thing. This is probably the most personal story I've done since becoming a chaser.
So I got to ask you, Ron, would you do it? I mean, I guess maybe it's easy in hindsight, and everybody would have that immediate reaction saying, wow, I don't know. But I don't know. Would you have that in you to grab a guy off a park bench and bring him inside, let him shower and have dinner with your family?
Well, you know what, Bill? It's so funny. It's that's why people do stuff like this. I saw it firsthand. I've never heard of that, you know, before. I've never seen that happen so quickly and so many hands in this pot to make this happen. The PBA, the police, the individual organizations. You see that happen, and it shows how one little act of kindness can snowball into a life-changing thing. And that's probably the most amazing part of this story. So, yeah, Bill, you know, do nicer things every day is the story here.
Yeah, well, I always used to object. I hear people with the slogan of random acts of kindness. This is not random. That to me never made any sense. This is very specific. April Steck would pass this guy every day. So she was acting in her own sphere. saying, I'm looking at this guy every day. I'm going to give him a sandwich. And that got the ball rolling. And I'll tell you, I don't think that the cops get enough credit either. That, you know, people love to just knock the cops all the time. There's this culture today that we got to have one eye open. You can't trust them. We need body cameras, all this stuff. Meanwhile, it's the PBA that put in the money and said, let's get this guy to reunite with his daughter in North Carolina.
Absolutely. You know, this snowball turned into, you know, a huge snowball very quickly. And Clinton is, you know, sometimes you talk about the homeless and the rehabilitation of the homeless and what you need to do. There's got to be some want there. You know, you build some self-respect and he made his way out. And we wish him all luck. We never know. Recidivism is very high. And you know, we wish him luck. He looks like he's doing great. And he's in great spirits.
Well, you did a great job with it, Rohan. And thanks for sharing that on New Jersey 101.5. I will certainly see you tomorrow. But it's a real heartwarming, positive Jersey story. And I appreciate all the great work you did chasing this down. And you can see that tomorrow night on Chasing News on Fox Television. Thanks, Rohan.
All right, Bill. Always nice to talk.